Hi, I'm Ken Fobb, and this is NewsNet Baton Rouge. So grab yourself a TR coffee as I go over with you the headlines for our area and region. The city of Baton Rouge is using data to flag potential domestic abusers in the latest defense against domestic violence. Local enforcement officials are working to identify domestic abusers in advance so that they can intervene before it's too late. It is part of a new initiative aimed at saving lives and reducing the high rate of domestic violence that has plagued Louisiana, but more particularly the Baton Rouge area in recent years. Louisiana as a whole has ranked as one of the top five states for the number of women killed by men each year. In Baton Rouge, domestic homicides rose to 14 in 2017, when murders in general also rose to an unprecedented level of 106 parish-wide. Officials now plan and pledge to devote more resources to tackle this problem. Therefore, offenders are often men with extensive criminal histories that include a wide range of crimes. And because the victims are often women living below the poverty line, according to this data analyzed over the past several months, researchers plan to use that data to help detect in advance and to hopefully reduce the high rate of domestic violence in our area. Researchers from the John Jay College of Criminal Justice will be using that data to help our local authorities develop a new program called Stop the Loss that will implement what is called focused deterrence, according to District Attorney Hiller Moore. Now, a Baton Rouge man has been accused of dumping the body of an overdose victim into an abandoned vehicle. Robert Lowe, 54 years old, who lives at 9854 Hooper Road, faces counts of unlawful disposal of human remains, failure to notify of death under suspicious circumstances, and obstruction of justice after the East Baton Rouge Parish Sheriff's Office arrested him. He told authorities that he went into his bedroom where his friend, a female, was, and he noticed that there were syringes, a spoon, and suspected narcotics on his dresser. He said that the two had sex earlier but fell asleep. But when he woke up around 3 a.m., the woman was on the floor and was not responsive. This is according to the arrest report. Now, Lowe says he put the woman's body on the floor of his vehicle and drove around Baton Rouge. And after finding an abandoned car on the dead-end street of Simplex Street, he placed the woman's body in the abandoned vehicle. And then he went back to his home and collected her personal items and disposed of them in a garbage can. He was released on an $80,000 bond. Now, in local education, Mr. Mike Godet, a retired Albemarle executive, easily won his bid to become the president of the East Baton Rouge Parish School Board by a unanimous vote of his peers. Mr. Godet has in the past been attacked by school teacher unions and has been celebrated by charter school groups. Mr. Godet says that the school board has a lot of issues to tackle this year, including likely deep cuts in the budget and the search for a new superintendent. Given that this school system is the second largest public school district in Louisiana, he says, after he spent decades as an executive in the business world, he has a strong background in finance and a strong background in working with large organizations, but he intends to lean heavily on the strengths of his colleagues. Finally, a former LSU student and fraternity brother who is accused of pushing another student down two flights of stairs during an August 2017 fraternity preview event has pled not guilty to the charges. Nicholas Daniel LaRusso II, a 21-year-old of New Orleans, appeared before State District Judge Don Johnson with his attorney, Kyle Kershaw, and entered a not guilty plea to simple battery and another misdemeanor. Mr. Nicholas LaRusso II is the son of former Republican State Representative Nick LaRusso of New Orleans. That's Nick LaRusso of New Orleans. He also pled not guilty to possessing marijuana stemming from a January 2017 event. Although he was originally arrested on a second-degree battery charge, which is a felony, the district attorney's office charged him with the lesser crime of simple battery in November. This incident took place at the Delta Kappa Epsilon house, and the incident actually occurred less than a month before the fatal September 14, 2017 hazing of LSU freshman Max Groover, which resulted in his death. These have been your headlines from NewsNet Baton Rouge. I'll see you next time. I'm Ken Fox.